Hey, Pastor Carl here with some really important information for you, one of our High Point Kids leaders, aka Dream Teamers. So please do take a few minutes, watch this whole video. I might even pester you to see if you watched it because there's a lot of important information in it. But first, I just want to share with you, at the worship night recently, we had a worship experience for early childhood, also for elementary. Over 50 kids came, it was fantastic. And yes, we had some adult care in the auditorium. But part of the service, I had the kids write out some prayer requests and put them on the wall. And they're a great reminder that we are doing ministry to kids where there's real issues going on in their home. We're not just doing the child care. That's why I make the jokes about adult care, because our kids need Jesus and our kids need to be ministered to. So I just grabbed a few random ones to read to you. I love this one. It just says, yeet. So there's a kid with a great sense of humor. I like this one. Dear God, help me to be lucky. I don't know if they're planning to play the lottery or struggling in school. But this one, a boy writes, dear God, thank you for my family. Thank you for my house. I love you. Thank you for my food and my health. Isn't that a great prayer? How about this one? Dear God, thank you for my family and friends. Please let me know how my dad is doing in heaven, because today is his and my mom's anniversary and I miss him so much. It's like a puzzle with a piece missing. Wow, that's powerful. And what about this one? It says, dear God, I wish you would talk to me when I feel sad, and I wish that you would change my dad's feelings about me just a little bit. I just wish he was a better person, and I don't like when he says cuss words around me. Please help him. Man, you never know what's going on in kids' houses. How about this one? Dear God, I want you to help my daddy to stop drinking and for him to pray to you, and I want my daddy to love you. Please help him. Oh, man. And then thank you, God, for everything you have given me, everyone you have let me live with, and my friends. Thank you, God, so much. And God, I hope the homeless will have a home and food and beds and blankets, clothes, and help. You got to give a little glimpse into the hearts of our kids, from the silly spectrum all the way to there's really tough stuff going on. And that's why everything we do is so important. Please know you are making a difference in the lives and the hearts of kids and the families that they come from. Well, the fall is here, and August 1st, we are kicking off some really exciting new things, some new lingo, some new rooms, some changes. So thanks for sticking with me as I walk you through them. August 1st is Promotion Sunday. That means the kindergartners get to go up to the outpost. Many have already found their way there over the summer, and we've just let them come whenever they're ready over the summer. But as of August 1st, it is K through fifth grade there in the outpost, and we move the kids up into our new room. So slight room changes, nothing major. Nursery is our base camp ministry because they start at base camp before they begin the ascent in their walk with God. And that is the same. That's zero all the way up through till they turn two. So even ones are in there. The next room over, next to the nursery that's adjoined to it, is going to be our twos room. Now, it's been closed for a while. We've had the twos and threes combined across the hall, but that's going to go back as of August 1st, being the two-year-old's room, just twos. And then across the hall, this room that I'm in right now, which a lot of people call Roscoe's Rally, and the room right next door are all going to be the threes through fives, because we are launching a brand new preschool worship experience August 1st called Jesus Jamboree. Now, it used to be called Roscoe's Rally, but we want the name to really communicate that it is about Jesus and it's fun. It's a jamboree. Hey, what? You're dropping my name. Oh, sorry, Roscoe. You'll still get to visit. All right. Yeah, Roscoe's not too happy about the name change. But Roscoe's Rally, or excuse me, Jesus Jamboree is going to be similar to Roscoe's Rally, but a whole nother level. It's going to have worship, and it's going to have Bible teaching, but There's also going to be learning centers, all right? There's going to be crafts. There's going to be really creative snacks, not just goldfish crackers. It's going to be amazing. So here's some of the changes that are being implemented as we ramp up to introduce a new preschool service to our kids on par with what we're doing over in the Outpost with our elementary targeted service. Now, God has brought someone to our church. Her name is Sherry Vance. She is the wife of a children's pastor, which means probably she did most of the work, right? Isn't that how it goes? Our wives are such a blessing to us. She's got multiple degrees. She's a licensed AG minister. She's a professional teacher, but her passion is the littles, as she calls them, on Sunday mornings, and she's going to be the service lead for Jesus Jamboree. Now, if you've been a storyteller, teacher, or a worship leader, you're still going to be involved, and we're still going to need you. But here's some structural changes we're making, really just with our name titles across the board in High Point Kids, all right? So service lead is the person in charge of the service. In Outpost, I would be the service lead. I'm the one that writes the curriculum, plans it all out, assigns different tasks like worship leader or whatever. And Sherry is the service lead for Jesus Jamboree, all right? Now, the other thing we're going to be adding new this year is something I'm calling room rangers, all right? We've had rangers in the Outpost, but a room ranger is the person who is in charge of that room for the hour that they're serving. So there's gonna be a room ranger in the nursery, in the twos, in the threes through fives, and even in the Outpost, because we wanna have that go-to person who's there early, opens up the room, makes sure everything's ready. They not only greet the kids, they greet the other volunteers who are serving, and they're gonna be responsible for the check-in and check-out, just making sure that we're faithful on the secure checkout. They can delegate it, but they'll be the ones making sure that we don't get lax in checking the security tags across the board of everyone, whether you know them or not. We always have to check those security tags. The only one that can make an exception is myself, so that I own that choice. So if you can't, you know, if they lose their tag, you go back to check in. They can reprint it sometimes. If they can't resolve it, then you just come get me. But the room rangers are something new that we're implementing, I think is really important as we grow. Now, after the room ranger are going to be trail guides. Now, we already use trail guides terminology in the Outpost. We're just going to do that across the board. So instead of just saying they're a helper or a volunteer, they're trail guides. I love that name because not only does it fit kind of our outdoor theme, but it says you're there to guide the kids through the various activities, help them know where they need to go, what they should be doing, helping them participate in different activities. And so we'll have the room ranger, and then we've got our trail guides. Now, one thing new with Jesus Jamboree is there's gonna be learning centers. And so we're also going to assign some of our trail guides each week to be activity guides, all right? So they're gonna own an activity so that they know what it is and help the kids through it. Sherry's planning all those. We're gonna have creative sessions. You can be a part of planning the crafts and the snacks and activities as well. And so when you get your requests in Planning Center, you're gonna be looking to see, have I been assigned as a room ranger, as a trail guide, as an activity guide? And that's gonna be kind of a new and exciting thing. Now, there's gonna be four activities, two each service, so that even the kids that are here two services, they'll get to do something new during the second service. It's not just gonna be a complete rerun of the first service. Similar to our Trailblazers, which also will have a room ranger and trail guides for second service for kids who already went to the Outpost. Now there's gonna be some creativity and some changes for the preschoolers who are here for two service, because we have a lot of awesome people who are serve one, attend one, you're some of those, and now their kids will have a little more variety in the second service. So that means that you're gonna wanna watch for those things. And one of the things we're gonna be also adding is we're gonna be splitting our huddle. We do a huddle every Sunday morning at 8:30 in the Outpost. You've seen my invitations to come. Our leaders come. Not as many people come, honestly, as I wish would see that as a priority to come. But we're going to be splitting that so that Outpost Huddle can really focus on here's what we're doing today, and here's what we need to know or be reminded of. And then we're gonna have a Jesus Jamboree Huddle at 8:30 in this room. And so if you are serving on a Sunday morning, please make it a priority to be here for the huddle. That's when activity leads. We'll find out what the activity is. That's when you'll find out what's unique about this Sunday. It's a time for some quick encouragement, some prayer, so that we really bathe the morning in prayer and ask God's blessing on our ministry to the kids. Even if you're serving in a 10:30 service, you still can come to the 8:30 huddle. All right, if you want to go grab a great seat in the auditorium, you can, but come to the huddle, learn what's going on. If you're serving at 9, then you're already there. You just start doing your work and greeting the kids and loving on them. If you're serving at 10:30, then you skedaddle off to big church, or as I like to call it, adult care, and then just come back at 10:30 and you'll be in the scoop. You'll know what's going. Helps us know who's here and who's not here, and if we need to make any last minute adjustments to our morning. So please make those huddles a priority starting August 1st. We may even have some giveaways and prizes in that we're planning for people who make that a priority. So some room changes, some name changes, a brand new preschool worship experience is coming, and I'm so excited about all of those things. A couple last quick reminders. Growth Track. You've heard about it. If you've not been to Growth Track, please go to our church website /Growth Track. Click on that and make sure you go to that. We want everyone to go through that so we're all on the same page. And yes, that might take you out of serving for a few weeks. We support that, all right? You also can take a few months to go through it. You can do week one month, and then you can do week two another month. You can even do the third week in a third month if you want. So work your way through Growth Track so that we all are on board with what God's doing in and through our church, and it's an enjoyable experience. You'll be glad that you did. Also, I want to make sure that you are on all of our social media. If you do social media, make sure you're in our Facebook group for the kids ministry. It is just for volunteers and parents. We don't let anybody from the outside. Every request I get, I look in our database. I make sure that person is associated with the church, because it's kind of in-house announcements, promotion, needs, and things like that. And if you're on Instagram, go ahead and follow High Point Kidmin, and that's just a fun place for pictures. We don't use that as much for information, but it's fun to share what God's doing in the ministry. If you're in the Facebook group, you've already seen my post about this guy. We are going to be building a set in this room. It's going to be amazing, right? We're going to have a TV mounted in the set, kind of like the outpost. There's going to be a puppet window over here. There's going to be a door, and there's going to be cubbies. And we're really wanting to create an amazing experience for our preschoolers. So this guy's got to go. So if this is something you would love to have in your backyard, then all you have to do is reach out to me and either bring a crew, bring your husband, say, hey, take this sucker apart, put it in the pickup truck. If you have no clue how to get that to your house, I might be able to rally up some guys to help transport this. But this has got to go by July 30th, because that's when we start building our new Jesus Jamboree set, and it's going to be fantastic. Lastly, if you're still watching, I'm extra thankful for you. Please continue to pray with me for our EC director position. Some of you know Cassie's been helping with the scheduling. Her school job is off for the summer. She's going to be going back to that job and won't be able to do that anymore. And if you guys know, we recently took in my wife's parents. It's a big adjustment for us. And so my wife's not even able to really take that on. She's been carrying that for months and months. And we've been without that position since the beginning of the year. So we need someone at a minimum to help with scheduling and planning center. Ideally, we want someone to really embrace and take on the EC director role. Sherry's leading the Jesus Jamboree, so you know that takes a lot of the work off of the EC director position. And ultimately, my prayer is for someone who really wants even a broader sense of ownership and responsibility as a children's ministry director to work with me in leading, in advancing, and moving forward the ministry of High Point Kids here at High Point Church. So pray with me, shake some trees, search your own heart, see if God might bring someone to mind, including yourself. We really want to fill that position. There's some wonderful things that we could be doing, a few that we should be doing that we just can't do without that position being filled. So I will see you on Sunday. Thanks again for all that you do to minister to our kids. And remember, there are some real hurts going on in the lives of our kids, and what you do is making a difference. Thanks.